just to let you know that all of the work we do up here, we'll take a picture of it and we're going to put it onto a PowerPoint presentation for you to see if you don't get it. This will all be on one central document. We'll have a listing link there. And this is going to be sort of our learning block. Thank you, Mr. Goodman, for the idea. And all of them will be dated and you just have a link to it. And if you need help, you can just see the picture of all our solutions that we've done up here.
Welcome to our new GCSE video. Today we're going to be talking about a triangle. Now you know that a triangle has three sides, but these sides have a special property to them. This side here, you know from Pythagoras' theorem, the longest side is called the hypotenuse. Spelled correctly. We tend to use the symbol H. Now you have an angle here. This angle is called theta. Theta is actually a Greek symbol for an angle. It's much easier to write this instead of the angle itself. The side opposite to the angle is called the opposite. And we give it the symbol O. Now this side here, the side that's not opposite or hypotenuse, is called the adjacent. Adjacent. And we give this letter A. But how does this triangle all link together? Well, I'm just going to rub this out. These words. Just for a second. If I have, for example, the length of the hypotenuse, whether that might be 15, and I don't know what this length is, I know that this length is X. I can use an equation to find out this length. Now the reason why you can't use Pythagoras is because you've only got one length, you haven't got the other. But wait, you've got an angle. But if you have an angle of 30 degrees, well, you have a side, you have an angle, and you have a side that you want to find. This is called trigonometry. It's the property of a triangle that you can use to find out all these angles and all these sides. The equation for this is sine theta, in this case sine 30, is equal to opposite, which in this case is x, over the hypotenuse, which is 15. I'm just going to write it over here. The sine theta equals to opposite, I'm just giving it O over h. It's a ratio, really, the ratio of the sides and the sine of the angle. How do you find x? Well, very simply, it's like solving an equation. You multiply the 15 onto the other side, you get 15 sine 30 equals x. On your calculator, there is a button, and I'm just going to get my calculator. There we go. Now, that calculator has a button called sine. If you write 15 sine, and it will open up a bracket. This bracket is where you put your angle, and you write the bracket 30, you write 30, you close the bracket, and you press equals. That will give you the result, and it will give you the length of the side x. And if I take this calculator here, the length is 15 over 2, which is sine 2b7.5. Now, units still, if this was centimetres, I would expect this to be centimetres, you could lose a mark. If you don't write the correct units. One good tip sometimes in an exam is just to remember as a fact, the sine of 30 degrees, because it's a degree angle, is always equal to 0.5. So it's just very simple. 15 times 0.5 gives me 7.5. This is another scenario as well. Remember just as I said previously, this is actually the adjacent, I'm going to call it A. What happens if we have the hypotenuse and we have the same angle, but we were asked to figure out the adjacent, given that to be X? Can't use sine, you haven't got the opposite. You've got the hypotenuse, you've got an angle, but you need a different function. By the way, we call these trigonometric functions, the function that you use in trigonometry to find out the side or an angle. Because this is adjacent, you use something else. You use something called the cosine. Short cos but this cosine, cos of theta, this is theta, is equal to adjacent over hypotenuse. The adjacent is this side here, this is underneath the angle, and the hypotenuse is along the side of the triangle. So, you substitute these values. You know that theta is 30 degrees. You know that the adjacent is something that you have to find, so you give this the value x. And you know that the hypotenuse is 15. Well, like we just did in the last method with the sine, what you can do is you can multiply 15. You get 15 cosine of 30. Now, there is no sine, so you can't use the sine button. But what you can do is there is also a cosine button. If you type in 15, then you press the cosine button, and then you type in inside the brackets 30, close the bracket, and press the equals button, you get a result. You can convert it to decimal if it's a fraction, and you will get the result, and I'm just going to write it down for purposes, 15 root 3 over 2. The answer that it gives you is, in full, on the calculator, 12.990381106. I'm just going to write this just a bit neater. In an exam, sometimes I'll ask you to write it to specific specific decimal places or significant figures. If they say to you, they want this answer to three significant figures, you'd write it as 13.0. You want these three significant figures, but you're going to take this number and you're going to see if that rounds it up or down. It's a 9, it'll round it up. But the next number I'll round up to is 13.0. Again, units you have to remember, that's centimetres. Logically, this will have to be centimetres as well. That was meters, that was meters. There's also one more. I'm just going to rub this out. We've continued discussing about having the hypotenuse as one of the given sides. What if the hypotenuse hasn't been given? What if, for example, they've said to you, they give you the adjacent? I'm going to make up a random value. Let's give it 10. Let's give it 10 centimetres. They ask you, what is the opposite side? Next. There isn't a hypotenuse. So you can't use any of these two functions. We have to have a third function. We do have that third function. It's called the tan function. The tan theta is equal to opposite over adjacent, where you get given the opposite, or you get given told to find the opposite, then you have the adjacent in 10 centimetres in this case. Similar method, you have the angle here, you substitute it as theta. Tan 30 equals x over 10. Well, you can multiply this 10. 10 tan 30 equals x. Now, to show where this button is, you've shown the sine button, you've just shown the cos button. But there's also a tan button just for this purpose. For this solution, you write 10, then you press the tan button, and inside the brackets that it gives you, you write 30. You close the brackets and you press the equals button. Now, after all this has been done, you get this answer. Now, you can use this button here, a bit faded out, it's called S to D, it's called third to decimal. It will give you a decimal solution. Now, the decimal solution that we have for this is 5.77350269292, I believe that's correct. 2692. Before I go any further, you have to remember units. And also, they ask us three significant figures. Well, this one is not going to, because this one is going to keep it normal. 5.77 centimeters. Now, we've just been talking about the three equations that we've been given. We said that they were sine theta equals opposite over hypotenuse, cos theta is given to be adjacent over hypotenuse, and also tan theta is given to be opposite over adjacent. When you're in an exam, you need to memorize these functions, and you need to know when to use them and how to recognize them when you get given certain signs. Sometimes it's very hard for us to know which equations to use, but there's also one method that that is very much commonly used in an exam. It's called SOP CAP TOA. I've just split this up, it's actually one whole word. You can use this to identify which equation you need. If you have an opposite and an adjacent, hypotenuse, apologies, use a SOP, sine, opposite, hypotenuse. If you have the adjacent and the hypotenuse, you use CAP, cosine, adjacent, and hypotenuse. So it would just be adjacent and hypotenuse, and then this one would be opposite hypotenuse. And if you have the opposite and the adjacent, the tan, opposite, adjacent. Using this as an example will help you to answer these questions. So, all you need to remember, SOP CAP TOA, sine, opposite, hypotenuse, cosine, adjacent, hypotenuse, the tangent of the opposite adjacent. Opposite hypotenuse, opposite hypotenuse, opposite.
Thanks for watching. Please hit the like button, subscribe, and could you please comment down below to let us know which topics you would like us to cover next. It really helps. Thanks.